Let's go.
A buoyant Sunderland arrived at the Den with 5'8" Joe Gelhard up front, and the lack of an obvious target man encouraged Mowbray to decide to play the ball on the floor and wide, especially down the right, where we have seen much success lately with Hume, Roberts and Ahmad interchanging with quick ball. I think we all imagined that, eventually, we would pirouette to victory without too much trouble. Millwall, for their part, came up with a solid, if ugly, plan to counter us and chose to try to dominate the midfield today in an effort to break up our play from the back, giving little space to Neil and Michu to build our attacks, and it was effective. Both saw little of the ball and were much less prominent today than in previous games.
Here's Jack Clark, chopped down in the middle. Play continues.
All over the midfield, Millwall tried to impose themselves and disrupt our play.
Michu. Surrounded by Millwall players, goes down. Referee's given the foul.
Bouncers crushing us here.
Right. Tries to go inside. Is taken.
There.
Goes down. Nice little drop off and then gets wiped out. Oh, surely a free kick. Gelhard again hacked down.
Remarkably, all these tackles would go by before a yellow card was produced for one on the 33rd minute. Outside the box and lacking height, Mowbray had instructed the team to play free kicks quickly, looking to get down the side and behind Millwall. But this was often nullified by a very heavy markup, which often saw Millwall overload our attack on the right and at the very least go tightly man for man. Effectively, this crowded us out. Switching play became difficult as Millwall frequently boxed us in, and this often led to too many passes and things not coming off for us. Then Millwall scored through ex-Sunderland captain George Honeyman.
Inside the area, pulls it back, shot goes in, it's gone round Patterson, and Honeyman finishes it, and he scores against his former club.
But a lengthy pause saw their celebrations turn to annoyance when the linesman refused to move until an offside query was resolved.
Well,
wait, Anthony Patterson's line of view.
It is nil-nil.
The ball's gone down.
That's the most important thing for Sunderland fans.
Let's have a look back now.
From the perspective of the linesman, Saville here is offside. What he does not know and cannot tell is whether this interferes with the goal. So he waits to speak to the referee, and after some consultation, the correct decision is arrived at, to the fury of Gary Rowett. Despite being disallowed, the goal was a warning sign for Sunderland. Whilst successfully disrupting our midfield from building any attacks, Millwall chose to largely bypass the midfield in their own to prevent us from winning any ball back. Millwall spent most of the day playing long balls. They played more long balls in the first half than any other team we played this season. I mean, this is the first 25 seconds of the entire match, and watch what happens.
Had a decent season.
George Long in goal this afternoon for Millwall. From a whole player, Sheffield United.
They played more long balls than any team in the whole game since, well, the last time we played Millwall.
McNamara floats one in. There's another player gone down there. Was Cooper.
Relying on their height to score, they were certainly much more organised around the second ball in the box today, closing off second balls in dangerous areas much more effectively than us. In a similar fashion on corners, we were mismatched in our zonal setup, leaving the big men of Cresswell and Cooper relatively free, unhassled runs onto the ball by using the short men as early blockers who clearly couldn't. Millwall captain Jake Cooper never went down at a corner when he got a free run to head the ball 6 yards out. But when more speculative balls came in, shallower and from further out, he pretended to be the most fragile person on the pitch. Here, he's apparently shoved over, aside from the fact that it's a certain dive. And this dive is followed by a blatant foul on Patterson.
For a penalty. Not even waved away by the referee.
I was looking for it.
Ball comes in. Patterson's underneath it. Gets there. Takes a clip as well. And Danny Barth's not happy about that one. It's Jake Cooper who's up from the back. He definitely left one.
His efforts at cheating, repeatedly diving, should have been booked. But it wasn't until gone half an hour that he found himself in the book, and that was for dissent. All of this made for a poor spectacle and a messy game today. It was like being back in League One and watching us struggle with Rotherham again. We lacked tempo today, and this was exaggerated by an aggressive Millwall who disrupted our pattern of play extremely effectively. Shortly after the restart, Millwall again felt aggrieved at being denied one of their many penalty claims.
All over the top, looking to bring in Watmore, and Patterson comes and gets clattered, but wins the ball.
So he watched it really well there. He's appealing.
Perhaps Cooper's ridiculous antics all game work against Watmore here. But really, Patterson is clearly just first to the ball, and plays a clear situation where he's likely to come off worse in. It's not a penalty. Millwall's disruption and press almost paid dividends minutes later when Wallace hits the bar.
You've got to get tight on him, can't give him space like that. No, it's not. It's Wallace, actually. Cameraman was focused on Cooper behind him.
And then Honeyman went close again.
Gets the ball on for McNamara. Cuts it back. Honeyman strikes! That's a good save from Patterson.
Yeah, it was, yeah. It just sets the cross. Tip it behind for the corner, but there's pressure building again from Millwall.
And from the resulting corner, the tallest man on the field, Jake Cooper, again found himself lying on the floor, but on this occasion managed to dink a looping ball into the far corner, and Millwall were ahead.
Boston gone in as well. It was Jake Cooper who I think was on the floor when he struck it.
Yeah, well, he's been a handful, hasn't he, in the air. He's won a lot of balls coming in, but that time it drops down. It's that second, third phase where we don't clear it. We're not dealing with it. Tedder, doesn't he? You see him there now, gets the run again. And I've not been happy with our setup from corners since the first one, to be honest.
Shortly after the restart, Mobe readied Pritchard in an effort to fix our misfiring. Michu was instructed to stay low alongside Neil to shore us up defensively, as Pritchard adopted a position high up the pitch behind Gelhardt to try and inject some tempo into our play.
Ballard.
Hume.
Millwall's bullying in the midfield continued. Here, Fleming makes absolutely no attempt to play the ball. This is a clear yellow, but no card is given. On the 66th minute, Mowbray introduced Cirkin for Elise to add fresh legs to an improving tempo for Sunderland. Roberts received the ball and ran almost the whole length of the pitch to a scoring position.
Roberts through the legs of Saville. Patrick Roberts still going, Patrick Roberts, and he's still going, Patrick Roberts! Can he get a shot away?
But instead of slotting in, Gelhardt probably felt he'd earned the shot himself. 10 minutes later, he was fouled again.
Legs of Honeyman. Roberts goes inside, but then gets caught by Saville.
Just gets away from him, he's just too quick there for Saville.
This left Pritchard stepping up to take the free kick.
For Sunderland, inside the final 10 minutes of normal time, there will be...
Pritch whipped in a great shallow ball that Cirkin put into the back of the net, but unfortunately Cirkin met the Oliver Kahn school of goalkeeping and was punched out cold by Long. Apparently when he came to, the first thing he asked was, did he score? Get in there, Dennis. Mowbray looked worried at losing his second left-back with no more on the bench. So Anderson came on for his debut as a left-footed defender. He went to left-back, and Ekwa replaced Michu to give some power to the midfield in front of this defence.
No, it is Ekwa.
Ekwa, yeah.
Did Barr come on as well?
As the game petered out, Mowbray brought on the last of the subs, Abdullah Barr for Gelhardt, who had been largely disappointing. He'd received little ball to do anything with, but when he had, he'd played some absurdly wild passes that went astray. I think it's going to take him some time to settle into how we play, and it's a worry that this young lad is expected to play every minute of every game between now and the end of the season. Surely we have to get in some short-term free to help us out, or all the good work that we've done this season might fall flat. Given the lengthy injuries to Honeyman for Elise Headbutt and Dennis Cirkin being knocked out, combined with the statutory 30 seconds extra time for each of the 8 substitutes put on in the second half, it was a surprise to see only 6 minutes of injury time at the end of the game.
Head injury there on Danny Bart.
And even an elbow on Danny Bart couldn't lengthen what was a pretty miserable game to watch. If we're to take any positives from today, they will be thin on the ground, but one will be that we didn't buckle under the pressure and somehow stuck in to grind out a draw. It was noticeable that we needed the return of Alex Pritchard to instill some tempo and organisation into the team in order to achieve this, though. Another bright light from the afternoon was the continued excellent performance of Trey the Hitman Hume, who was excellent in defence today. Hume had 98 touches, more than any other player on the pitch. He made most of the clearances along the back line. He made most tackles along the back line. Likes a hard tackle, does our Hume. He won 10 out of 12 ground duels. That's more than all of the rest of the back line put together. I think there's no question that Trey Hume keeps his place when Gooch is fit again. Overall, I'm glad that this game has finished. It was certainly a negative setup for Millwall. The tactics were designed to prevent us from playing rather than win the game. But credit to them, Millwall are perhaps the first team I've seen this season who have come up with an effective way to nullify us. It wasn't great to watch, though. Imagine if we make the playoffs and meet this one again. See you next time. If you made it this far, well, thanks for watching. Give me a thumbs up, I guess, if you liked it. Share, subscribe if you liked it a lot, and you'll get a notification when the next one of these reviews comes out. Thanks a lot.